11 wins and one loss. A Fiesta Bowl victory. High national ranking. Two All-America selections. ...1977, a Penn State football year of considerable accomplishment. And when it was all over in Tempe, Arizona, what a great season for everyone to reflect upon, including Coach Joe Paterno.
I'm proud of our record, our bowl victory, our total success, but the thing I remember most about this 1977 Penn State football team is its dedication, its enthusiasm, its togetherness, its contagious spirit.
The Penn State spirit gets moving on a warm September night at Giant Stadium, East Rutherford, New Jersey, in the season opener with Rutgers. In the first quarter, Matt Suey scores twice, from 2 yards out and from 51 yards out. In the second quarter, Mike Gooman scores twice. Quarterback Chuck Fusina gets his record-breaking season underway with a touchdown pass to Bob Bassett. And Matt Barr's field goal gives the Nittany Lions a 38-0 halftime lead. Fullback Bob Torrey adds the final score with a 9-yard burst. A 504-yard total offense. Solid defensive play by Gary Peter Kuski, Bruce Clark, Matt Millen, Bill Banks, Randy Sidler, Joe DeAnge. The result, a big score opening win for Penn State.
Right, and I don't think we're that many points better than Rutgers either, Jim. I say many times, when you win, you're not as good as you think you are, and you're not as good as you look when you win, and vice versa when you lose. You're not as bad as you look when you lose, and I think that's the thing. Rutgers made some bad plays early in the game, didn't play as well as I'm sure they can. We played exceptionally well for the first game, didn't make many mistakes, and as a result, the difference in the score was a lot bigger than maybe the ability of the two teams.
On to Beaver Stadium for four consecutive home games, the largest Penn State home crowd ever. The students welcome their team, already have them number one. Matt Suey welcomes the Houston Cougars with a 53-yard run, setting up an early Penn State touchdown. Houston's A. Lois Blackwell makes it even, but not for long. Another big play, Chuck Fusina, to tight end Mickey Schuler, resulting in the first of two Matt Barr field goals. A duck under by Fusina and a direct connection with a leaping Scott Fiske gives the Lions a lead that built to 20-14 at halftime. This is some catch. In the second half, after the defense forces a turnover, cornerback Neil Hutton recovers for Penn State. Fusina comes pitching again. And Matt Millen comes sacking again. Penn State defenders completely shut out the explosive Houston offense, while the Penn State offense put another field goal and a touchdown on the scoreboard, and Penn State notched win number two, a 31-14 win over the Cotton Bowl champions. The next week, another Beaver Stadium sellout. The Terrapins of Maryland are the visitors. And the two squads are eager to get on with it. Less than 2 minutes into the action, the Fusina to Fitzky aerial show brings 62,000 plus fans, pom-poms and all, out of their seats. Blue and white enthusiasm for a truly remarkable catch. Matt Barr's fifth field goal of the young season gives Penn State a 3-0 lead. But Maryland battled to a tie on the last play of the first half. In the third quarter, people like Bruce Clark, Tom DePasso, and Joe Lally checked the Terps early. So, time for the big play offense again. A 58-yard scoring bomb, Chuck Fusina to Jimmy Cephalo, putting the Lions up 10-3. The spirit is beginning to catch on. Maryland's total offense in the third quarter was 22 yards. The Penn State defense was what? The offense comes with the reverse to Cephalo, a touchdown pass, Fusina, to Mike Dooman. And after Randy Sidler blocked a field goal attempt, wrap it up with a Tony Capozzoli to Cephalo touchdown pass. This is a fun team, a together team. Jimmy Cephalo and Tom DePasso talk about that on the offensive line.
It's just an enjoyable team to play with people like John Dunn and Eric Cunningham and Keith Thorney. And those people, I mean, if you talk to an avid Penn State fan, you might ask who Eric Cunningham is, and somebody might say they didn't know, when he's probably one of the most intricate part of our team, along with the rest of those kids. And it's just fun to play with them.
Well, the one thing that I noticed in preseason was, okay, it seemed like everybody helped everybody else. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like you were just out there trying to make it through, and it seemed like somebody did something good, you know, you'd be slapping them on the back or something, say, good job. And that seemed like we were more together as a team rather than just individuals, and I thought, you know, that's really good.
I think there probably is. I think everyone, you know, everyone not really hustles a little more, but everyone is a little more really intense in there and, you know, puts out a little more.
That was Randy Sidler talking about hustle and dedication. And Ron Hostetler even gets the coaching staff into the act.
I've really been enjoying the season. The coaches have created an excellent atmosphere out there. I'm sure the older they get, the wiser they get.
But onto each squad, some rain must fall. The third real tough one on the early season schedule. The University of Kentucky. It sure starts well enough for the Nittany Lions. A picture punt return. The Fusina touch. The Gooman scamper. But it ends better for the Wildcats. The clock was running out on a three-game winning streak for the Nittany Lions. Time to congratulate the winners and get to work on a new winning streak of 7 or maybe 8 games. Utah State would be the first to jump on, and the Nittany Lion mascot and another sellout crowd at Beaver Stadium watch the Penn State backs jump on and over and around and through and into the Aggies. The running backs carried the ball 78 times for nearly 350 yards. Coach Paterno explains.
We simply felt we had to run the football more than we had been. We were becoming a little bit more dependent on the pass. And I think this game gave us the opportunity to make a good offensive line better and tough runners tougher.
among Penn State's leading receivers, defenders, Randy Sidler. Neil Hutton. The new win streak was underway. Syracuse, New York. Archbold Stadium. The sun is shining, but not entirely on the Penn State football family. Joe Paterno was not with his team. Joe and Sue's son David had been seriously injured. Joe was with his wife and son at Geisinger Medical Center. Penn State squad takes the field with assistant coaches Bob Phillips and Jerry Sandusky in charge, and with the help of a staff Joe has many times called the best in college football. Freshman Booker Moore returns the opening kickoff 65 yards to the Syracuse 37. Steve Geist leaps over for the game's first touchdown. Excellent offensive balance. The pass. The run. Put the Lions on top at halftime, 24-10. Then power them to a 31-10 third quarter lead behind Steve Geist. That excellent offensive line, and Matt Sui. Syracuse quarterback Bill Hurley kept scrambling, and running, and passing to keep the Orange in it, but the Lions win it. The Penn State team is back at Beaver Stadium. David Paterno is recovering. Coach Joe Paterno is with his team. And the Penn Staters tell the world who they are. The opposition, West Virginia. And perhaps the turning point of the game for the Mountaineers was the introduction of the captains.
Come the ends, Captain Geist. Captain Pride Moore, Captain Gatewood.
Fourth play of the game, West Virginia in punt formation.
Holding the football.
Block. Can run it in. Can run it in. Matt Millen. Matt Millen runs it in for a touchdown.
Penn State 7, West Virginia nothing. With 2:41 gone in the first quarter, Joe Lally sacks Mountaineer quarterback Dan Kendra. Next play, Chuck Fusina to Mickey Schuler. Penn State touchdown. The Lions 14, West Virginia nothing. 4:36 first quarter. Randy Sidler crunches the quarterback. Riley fumbles. Rick Donaldson recovers for the Nittany Lions. Steve Geist for the touchdown. Penn State 21, West Virginia nothing. Elapsed time, 4:46. The game wasn't over, and the balance continued. Booker Moore on the run. A Fusina to Fitzke pass play. Not just your ordinary pitch and catch, mind you. To top off the day, the fans are treated to a Cephalo punt return. and a pass interception by Bruce Clark, a defensive tackle turned halfback. Penn State is 6-1, and just how good is this team?
They're right on the verge of being one of the really good football teams we've had here at Penn State, and I hope they just continue to, you know, to get better, and I think the West Virginia game was an opportunity for them to really go out there with everything, you know, offense, defense, a kicking game, the specialty teams, everybody was really in it and did a great job.
The next week, at home with Miami, and the beat goes on. It becomes apparent that this team is indeed on that verge that Coach Joe Paterno just talked about. The ingredients are certainly there. Aggressive, alert defense. Extremely strong running. Protection, the quarterbacking, the excellent receiving necessary for a productive pass offense. Number 14, Chuck Fusina, certainly has become one of America's premier college quarterbacks. Through eight games, Chuck has completed 95 passes for 1,511 yards and directed a running attack for 1,974 yards. But there are more tests to pass. The immediate one, the North Carolina State Wolfpack in Raleigh, North Carolina. The Nittany Lions scored first. Fusina to Cephalo. Penn State 7, North Carolina State nothing. The Nittany Lion defense stops the pack on the goal line in the first quarter. And Joe Dimenick forces them to settle for a field goal in the second quarter as Penn State took a 7-3 lead to the locker room at halftime. In the second half, it's the Nittany Lions against Ted Brown. Wolfpack taking a 17-14 lead in the fourth quarter. And that's how it stood with 2:35 remaining and Penn State at its own 17. Mr. Cool, Chuck Fusina to Jimmy Cephalo. In North Carolina State territory, Matt Sui goes to the 21 on the draw. And for the excitement of the finish, let's join Ray Scott and George Paterno on the Penn State football show.
It will be second and eight at the North Carolina State 19-yard line. Here they come. Here come the linebackers. He's open. Cephalo. He's at the 11-yard line. First down at the 11.
Penn State had come from behind on the road against a good team and won. Back home for the final 1977 Beaver Stadium appearance. It represents a nostalgic time for seniors like the nine captains, Craig Brown, Tony Williott, Tony Gordon, Dwayne Taylor, Dave Bodle, Bruce Austin, Clyde Corbin, Rob Shukri, and Bill Glenn. Penn State fans who have become accustomed to all kinds of weather watch and cheer and shiver. The Penn State football players just do their thing. Faithful are treated to a big win. And the magic of number 44. More seniors who provided this Penn State team with the leadership quality that contributed to the overall success. Let's meet them. Jimmy Cephalo, Pittston, Pennsylvania. Steve Geis, Flemington, Pennsylvania. Tom DePasso, White Plains, New York. Mickey Schuler, Enola, Pennsylvania. Neil Hutton, Mount Holly, New Jersey. Ron Hostetler, Holsopple, Pennsylvania. John Dunn, Hillsdale, New York. Bill Banks, Camden, New Jersey. Gary Peter Kuski, Lawrenceville, New Jersey. All-American Randy Sidler, Danville, Pennsylvania. Jody Ange, Massapequa Park, New York. The home season is over. Next year, a different stadium and hopefully different weather. But now it's time for the Pitt Panthers. There had been a great deal written considerable verbalizing about the 1977 Penn State-Pitt football game the 2 weeks before. It's time to play it. And the Nittany Lions are ready. The Lions waste no time as Pittsburgh area native Chuck Fusina hits Jimmy Cephalo on a 48-yard pass play. Kicks the field goal. Penn State leads 3-0. Pitt's Matt Cavanaugh scores the game's first touchdown, and the Panthers lead 7-3. The next Pitt drive stops when Ron Hostetler intercepts in the end zone. In the third quarter, another Bar field goal, then perhaps the season's most memorable play. Punt return reverse, Cephalo to Gooman. All the way for a touchdown. That's certainly worth another look. State regains the lead 12-7. In the fourth quarter, leading rusher Steve Geis breaks one for 27 yards. Matt Barr chips the ice away and calmly kicks his third field goal of the game, putting the Lions on top 15-7. But with 1:12 remaining, Cavanaugh connects with Gordon Jones, and Pitt is within 2 points. The game is on the line, and so are the Nittany Lion defenders. The two-point conversion attempt fails, and Penn State wins, completing a super 11-1 season. Time now to get back to Nittany Valley sunshine and preparation for Arizona State and the Fiesta Bowl. Time now to head for Arizona and the Camelback Inn. After all, it is Christmas Day. There are floats, of course. A huge pinata and balloons are there.
And Coach Joe Paterno and the rest of the Penn State squad.
The Nittany Lions' performance in the Fiesta Bowl was really a composite of all the things that made the 1977 Penn State football team as good as any in the nation, and pointed up the superb coaching job by the staff in all phases of the game. All-American Keith Dorney, John Dunn, Paul Renaud, Eric Cunningham, Chuck Correll, Irv Pankey, and Marty Sirosinski anchored an outstanding offensive line. Scott Fitzke handled the punting and left little to be desired. He put 12 inside the 20. The eager defenders blocked 5 kicks, 3 of which resulted in touchdowns. The punt return, one of the game's most exciting plays. Penn State had 6 big ones, 3 for touchdowns. Matt Barr scored 91 points, handled kickoffs nearly perfectly, and the coverage was physical. The get-to-the-ball defense recovered 16 fumbles, broke up 37 enemy passes, intercepted 19. And the pass offense featured receivers Shuler, Cephalo, Fitzke, and Bassett. And junior quarterback Chuck Fusina completed nearly 58% of his passes for more than 2,300 yards, had already broken or tied 9 Penn State passing records. The running game? Junior Bob Torrey averaged more than 6 yards per carry. Sophomore Matt Suey was the leading ground gainer as Penn State got nearly 1,200 yards from the fullback position. Senior Steve Geis gained 550 tough, important yards. As the season zeroed out, Penn State followers everywhere will recall those statistics and shout, "Look out for next year." But I get the feeling the players and probably the coaches too will share Coach Paterno's observation.
But the thing I remember most about this 1977 Penn State football team is its dedication, its enthusiasm, its togetherness, its contagious spirit.
What next for those seniors? Perhaps Bill Banks says it best.
I really don't know. I think I want to stay here forever.
State spring football practice, 1978. Preparation time. The squad and staff are hard at it. Nittany Lion fans everywhere are having good thoughts about this team. really looking forward to the season, the schedule, and a brand new stadium. Yes, Old Beaver is undergoing a facelift, literally. During spring practice, throughout the season, and at this very moment, a proud and loud proclamation rings out. We are Penn State. After a nervous 10-7 win over Temple in the season opener at the Vet in Philadelphia, the Nittany Lions opened new Beaver Stadium against Rutgers. After taking a three-point lead, Pete Harris, starting his first game at safety, intercepts. On the next play, Chuck Fusina connects with Scott Fitzke. It's a 53-yard scoring bomb that gives Penn State a 10-0 first quarter lead. Junior linebacker Lance Mell has adapted well to a new position and picks up his first interception of the year, resulting in another field goal and a 13-3 halftime lead for the Lions. In the second half, junior defensive tackle Matt Millen gives the fans a preview of the aggressive defense that is Penn State and will be Penn State throughout the 1978 season. Barr adds two more third quarter three-pointers. And in the fourth quarter, the strong running of Matt Suey features an 11-play, 82-yard drive. Penn State goes 2-0 with a 26-10 win over the Scarlet Knights. Ohio Stadium, Columbus. Penn State fans have been thinking and talking about the Penn State-Ohio State game for months and months. The talking turned to downright cheering as Pete Harris intercepts on the first Buckeye possession. Increases to a steady roar as a Fusina to Mike Gooman pass run play sets up the game's first score. A 30-yard field goal by Matt Barr. At the time, no one realizes the Nittany Lions already had enough points to win the game. But then no one knew the Nittany defenders would show such little respect for the OSU quarterbacks. Catch this defensive solo by sophomore defensive end Larry Kubin. And this interception by number 99, senior middle guard Tony Petruccio. In the third quarter, Penn State marched 80 yards and 13 plays for the game's only touchdown. Fusina to Bassett for 17. Matt Suey for 11 tough yards. Mike Gooman gets 8 more. Then Suey for the score. And Penn State leads 10-0. Matt Barr adds 3 more field goals in the fourth quarter. Lance Mell and Joe Lally add interceptions 4 and 5 for the day. And the second defensive unit preserves the shutout. Some observers suggested the Buckeye zero is because of Coach Hayes' quarterback selection. Coach Paterno, thinking of his team, did not agree with that suggestion.
But I'm just getting tired of people saying, well, if he hadn't done this or if he hadn't done that, why maybe they threw the game away to us because of their selection of a quarterback, which is utter nonsense. We're just a better football team than Iowa State, and I would have beaten them whether Gerald played or Schleister played or what they had done. We just happen to be better this year than they are, and I think it's unfair to our squad to make it sound as if a selection of a quarterback would have made the difference in the game.
Back home to host the Passon Methodists of SMU. The first half was the Matt Barr show. In fact, after 3.5 games, Barr had accounted for more than half of Penn State's points. But Matt didn't sit still for any criticism of the offense.
I think the offense has taken a lot of flack for unjustly. If they get the ball down deep in the other team's territory 10 times, if you score a touchdown every time, that's a 70-point game. But the offense has just been playing great.
As though to take the cue, and after trailing 21-12 early in the second half, the Lion offense begins to roar. Completed pass to freshman tailback Joel Coles. A 69-yard, 9-play drive culminates with a Fusina to Fitzky touchdown pass. The offense, of course, couldn't get the ball without Millen and Clark and company. And the offense knows what to do with that ball. A blast by Booker Moore. Another Suey score. The Lions complete today with 422 yards total offense and a come-from-behind 26-21 win. The TCU Horned Frogs got off on the wrong foot. A fumble on the first scrimmage play. Penn State recovers. On the next play, it's Booker Moore for the touchdown. Penn State 7, Texas Christian nothing, just 10 seconds into the game. Things didn't get much better for the visitors. Paul Suey and Matt Millen crunched the quarterback. Fusina to Bassett. Penn State touchdown. Another sack by Tony Petruccio. Fusina to sophomore tight end Brad Scoville. Penn State touchdown. Penn State's balanced offense produces 28 points in the first half. Balance continues in the second half with the Fusina-Fitzky combination. Good hard running from Suey and Moore. In all, it's an 8-touchdown, 1-safety, 450-yard afternoon for the hustling Lions and the season's second shutout for the defense. A night game in Lexington, Kentucky is next, and how Penn Staters do remember the Wildcats. Joe Paterno is looking forward to it.
It ought to be a fine football game, the kind of game we want this time. As I told the squad, you know, I think it's great that you're at this stage where you've got a lot of things that are right out there, playing for a lot of marbles, and you're going down someplace where you've not played well. Last time down there, we were absolutely humiliated, we were horrible, and I think this is a great opportunity for us to get down there and play the best football game we can play and just let things, you know, fall where they're going to fall, and I'm really looking forward to it. I'm excited about this one.
Matt Suey and friends are excited too, and are they ready? The Lions drive 61 yards on their first possession for the first score of the game. Chuck Fusina pitches a masterpiece, hitting 8 different receivers, including Booker Moore, Brad Scoville, and Scott Fitzky 5 times. There was indeed some excitement and some emotion. Fusina just keeps pitching to Tom Donovan. To Irv Pankey. The defense plays with excitement and emotion too, allowing the Wildcats just 36 yards and 1 first down on the ground, recovering 2 fumbles and intercepting 2 passes. This one by senior Rich Malott. The Nittany Lions are 6-0. Looking for 7 against old rival Syracuse on homecoming weekend. Traditional homecoming activities the night before the game make State College and Penn State something special. The next day, the orange is burned early. That now so familiar combination, Chuck Fusina to Scott Fitzke. A crowd-pleasing combination, too. Sophomore Mickey Urquhart blocks a punt. And Matt Millen scores a touchdown. And the aerial circus continues. Fusina passes for 293 yards. And a school record 4 touchdowns. It's another big score win for the rampaging Lions, who have averaged nearly 40 points per game the last 4 times out. The wonderful Lions visit wild West Virginia. Morgantown and the Mountaineers have been mighty friendly to Penn State over the years, but become downright inhospitable at the outset of the game. All of a sudden, it's West Virginia 14, Penn State nothing. The Lions have had the ball for just 2 plays. The kicking game comes through to produce 14 points for the Nittany Lions. Joe Lally comes up with the way you're supposed to do it, blocked punt, resulting in a Matt Suey touchdown. Mike Gooman goes the distance with a punt return. 85 yards. Senior fullback Bob Torrey joins the 400-plus yard offense, and the Lions don't slow down, scoring 42 unanswered points. Scoring them with plays like this unbelievable touchdown grab by Scott Fitzke. A Carl McCoy interception gets the ball back for the offense. Two fullbacks, Bob Torrey then Tony Alghero, wind up the scoring in a 49-21 win. Thoughts are now turning to the following week, a classic confrontation, undefeated Penn State hosting undefeated Maryland. The night before the game, a huge pep rally in Rec Hall.
And these guys sitting around here, the ones you're cheering on and praising, I'd have worked harder than any football team I've ever been around. Not this year, but last year, through a summer, through a winter program, through everything. And they're right there now where baby they can taste it and grab it. And I don't think they're going to foul it up.
They surely did not foul it up. At the stadium the next day, a record-setting 78,019 fans and a national television audience watch a masterful defensive performance. Greg Jones, number 70. Bruce Clark, 54. Mike Gilson, 37. Matt Millen, 60. Paul Suey, 65. Stopped the Terps' ground game cold. 2 Maryland quarterbacks were sackees 10 times. Millen. Lance Mell, number 56. Clark, Kubin, and Kugler were everywhere. Rushing for the Terrapins, minus 32. The offense was there too, with Gooman, Suey, Moore, and Torrey rolling for 210 yards on the ground. Matt Barr kicks 33 and 44-yard field goals. Fusina connects with Donovan, Pankey, Bassett, Gooman, Suey, and Moore for 234 yards. The offensive line, anchored by seniors Eric Cunningham, Chuck Correll, and Keith Dorney, blow people out. If there was ever a total team victory, Penn State's stunning 27-3 win over Maryland was it. The Nittany Lions are 9-0 with two to go.
Defend the goal.
We'll receive.
And which goal do you want to defend?
Defend the score up here.
Just turn around and face the way you're going, gentlemen.
North Carolina State, something of a nemesis, and Ted Brown is back.
All right, play football, gentlemen.
The nation's best collegiate football defense gets a hold of Ted Brown. North Carolina State does score. Yes, it's Brown, to take a 7-3 halftime lead. In the third quarter, the Lion ground game gets the ball into field goal territory with runs like this fine piece of work by Mike Gooman. A 44-yard ramble by Bob Torrey sets up Barr's fourth field goal of the game, and Penn State holds a slim 12-10 third quarter lead. No touchdowns yet for the home team. But the defense keeps the pack deep in North Carolina State territory. And Matt Suey takes care of the no touchdown situation with a heart-stopping, game-clinching 44-yard punt return that jumps the Nittany Lions into first place in both wire service polls. And now there's one to go. For the first time in 4 years, the Penn State Pitt game is being played at University Park. In a series that's had its share of thrilling games and cold weather, on this day, the fans are treated to both. Early in the game, an alert Rick Donaldson recovers a Pitt fumble. The Lions capitalize as Mike Gooman scampers in for the score. Pitt comes back midway in the second quarter, successfully makes a key first down, and ties the score with a touchdown pass. Trocano to Gostek. Then a field goal gives the Panthers a 10-7 third quarter lead. The fourth quarter, it belongs to Penn State. In the final period, Pitt's total offense was 18 yards as the defense did its thing. The offense gets it going, and as the Lions move deep into Panther territory, we're moving to the final 5.5 minutes of the game. To set the scene, Penn State is trailing 10-7. It's fourth down at the Pitt 4. Time for Matt Barr. It's fourth down and less than 2 yards. Not time for Matt Barr. The Lions are going for it. Watch and listen as Ray Scott and George Paterno describe three big plays that clinched an 11-0 season for the deserving Lions.
Two wide receivers to the right, fourth and two at the Pitt 4. Here goes Gooman.
Championship teams have made them.
They took the challenge, they picked up the gauntlet, and they really took it in for the big play. Great blocking on the left side of the line.
First and 15. Tricano. Over the middle.
Intercepted by Rich Malala.
Matt Barr will try for a new NCAA record of field goals in one season. This is his, if he is successful, will be number 22. Bassett holds, Drazenovich will snap. He has the distance. NCAA record. And Penn State leads 17-10 with 2 minutes and 23 seconds left to play in the game. Number 10, Matt Barr, a new record of most field goals in a season.
An undefeated season, an accomplishment no other major college football team was able to achieve in the 1978 season. A number one ranking is a good feeling. Time for celebration. Time to shop around for some new goalposts. Time to think about New Orleans. The Superdome in Sugar Bowl Town. It's Penn State and Alabama in the game billed as the one for the national championship. For the gallant Nittany Lions, it's a peak and valley emotional experience as well as a very tough football game. The Tide takes a 7-0 lead, scoring on a touchdown pass with 8 seconds remaining in the first half. In the third quarter, the Lions dominate. And tie the game at 7 with this sensational play. As you can see, the same great blue and white fan support was there. Alabama comes back with a big punt return and the go-ahead touchdown with this sweep. As it had done all season long, the defense comes up with a big play. Later, so does Alabama. Disappointment, of course, but never a loss of perspective, co-captain Paul Suey reflects.
You know, we've gone through so much together. You know, we started off in, essentially, we started last winter working the winter program in the spring and the summer. And then, you know, we start off in August as a team practicing when it's warm out. And we go through the season, and you know, you go through exciting times, the games, you know, before the game, after the game. And you know, we go into the cold weather, and now we go down to New Orleans and play in a great game down there. So we have so many memories together. We've been so close and gone through so many things that I think it, you know, we're all best friends, and we will be, you know, from now on.
What does the coach have to say?
It was a great year for everybody, and as I tried to tell the squad after the disappointing loss down in New Orleans, that I hope that they would remember the 1978 season at that moment. We'd remember all the great things they had done and accomplished, and all the excitement they had provided for people, and the way and the great football they had played throughout the year.
Great football is right. Football that produced 6 All-Americans. Kicker Matt Barr, senior, State College, Pennsylvania. The best single-season field goal kicking record in the history of college football. Keith Dorney, senior, offensive tech. This Lehigh Valley, Pennsylvania product is a 2-time All-American, and in 1978, an academic All-American as well. Quarterback Chuck Fusina, McKees Rocks, Pennsylvania. Senior, holder of 18 Penn State passing and total offense records. Maxwell Trophy winner, Heisman runner-up. Junior Pete Harris, Mount Holly, New Jersey, safety. Has a couple of brothers that play some football. The nation's interception leader. the dynamic duo. The Millen and Clark expedition. Junior defensive tackles Bruce Clark, Newcastle, Pennsylvania. Matt Millen, Hakandakwa. On the field and off the field, it's togetherness. Matt Millen, whose spirit is matched only by his talent. Bruce Clark, the peaceful giant who won the ABC Defensive Player of the Year Award and the prestigious Lombardi Award presented to the nation's outstanding college lineman. What do these three junior All-Americans and the returning underclassmen do for an encore in 1979? Coach Paterno knows.
You either get better or get worse. You can't, and we don't aim to be poorer football team than we were last year. And we don't aim to be poor. We can't stay the same. We're going to get better.
Getting better happens on the practice field, preparing for a 1979 schedule that includes eight teams with winning records in 78, six of them, Maryland, Nebraska, North Carolina State, Pittsburgh, Rutgers, and Texas A&M, appeared in postseason bowls. And in 1979, as in 1978, and for many, many years to come, the proud shout will be, we are Penn State.